As we continue looking at the types of chemical reactions, let's focus on double replacement reactions, which are often called metathesis reactions. Double replacement reactions take place when two elements within a compound are replaced. The ions in the compound get swapped. You have the general formula here. If you have a compound that is made up of AB and a compound that is made up of CD, remember that the positive ion is always written first, followed by the negative ion. In the products, A and D end up together. The positive ion from here ends up with the negative ion from here. And the other compound is the positive ion from here with the negative ion from here. So both elements within the compound get replaced and the ions are swapped. We're going to use this general formula to predict the products for some reactions. Keep in mind, anytime you form new products, you should always put the cation first, followed by the anion, and you should cross down your charges to make sure that your subscripts are correct. And then finally, you should always make sure that the reaction is balanced using coefficients. In my first example, magnesium oxide is my AB, and potassium chloride is my CD. So it's going to produce A and D. The magnesium and the chloride are going to come together to form a compound. The formula for magnesium chloride is MgCl2, and that comes from crossing down the charges. Magnesium has a charge of +2, and chloride has a charge of -1. You would cross those down to get MgCl2. And you should do that anytime you form a new compound to make sure that your subscripts are correct. The next portion is C and B coming together. So the potassium and the oxygen are going to come together to form a compound. That's going to give us potassium oxide, K2O. The two, once again, came from crossing down charges. Potassium has a charge of +1, oxygen has a charge of -2. Cross those down to get potassium oxide. The final thing that you should do is make sure that your reaction is balanced by adding coefficients. In this case, a coefficient of a 2 is needed here to balance out the number of potassiums and chlorides. In my second example, AB is sodium bromide and CD is calcium sulfide. A and D are going to come together, so sodium and sulfide are going to come together to form a compound. You would once again cross down the charges. Sodium has a charge of +1, sulfur has a charge of -2, cross those down to get Na2S. Finally, the C and B are going to come together, so calcium and bromine are going to come together to form calcium bromide. Calcium has a charge of +2, bromine has a charge of -1, cross those down to get CaBr2. The last thing that you should do is to confirm that the reaction is balanced. In this case, a coefficient of a 2 is needed here in order to balance the sodiums and the bromides. My final example uses one of our polyatomic ions. OH is the polyatomic ion hydroxide. That is taking the place of the B. So the potassium is a polyatomic is B. That is going to stay together in the reaction. So I have potassium hydroxide as AB and sodium chloride as CD. A and D are going to come together. So potassium and chloride are going to form the compound potassium chloride. My charges, potassium is +1, chlorine is -1. No additional subscripts are needed for that compound. And then finally, the C and the B. Sodium and hydroxide are going to come together to form a compound. The sodium has a charge of +1. The hydroxide has a charge of -1. No additional subscripts are needed. This reaction is balanced the way it is written. That wraps up a quick introduction to double replacement reactions. However, stick around. We're going to look at specific types of double replacement reactions called precipitation reactions. We're going to look at solubility rules and net ionic equations in the next video.